In 1883, Bruckner wrote to a friend about Wagner, who was in very poor health. And he writes this: "One day I came home and I felt very sad. The thought had crossed my mind that before long the master would die, and then the C-sharp theme of the Adagio came to me." Wagner did actually die in Venice that year. It is a very sad movement, incredible beautiful, very intense. It's also the first time that he uses the Wagner tubas, four of them. The big crescendo, which is built up in this movement, is, in my opinion, the fear which is built up. To get the message, actually, that Wagner will die. And then he gets the message that he died, and that's the outburst of the symphony. Altogether, I think this movement is the keystone of this symphony. There is an incredible intensity in the silence, and there is an incredible beauty in the silence as well. So, for an orchestra, it's very important to understand, and also as a listener, to understand that when it stands still, that he wants to give a view of the afterlife. I think that the moment, although it is sometimes a standstill moment, that you can still understand where the music is going to and what is the shape of the phrase, that is always for us, I think, as musicians and also as a listener, the moment that we still keep understanding and keep the heartbeat of the music. And I think a very important moment for these moments in the music is the relationship between audience and players. Because we do it, how strange this would sound, we do it together. It is a communication and an understanding of what we are doing and from our point of what they want to hear. And this is something which goes like this, instead of, need to be very careful that there should not be a wall between the musicians, the music, and the audience. He did not do any concession to his public. No, he really lived in his own world and he believed in it. He lived in his church almost. Of course, he played the organ at ceremonies. And then after that, he was of course composing. And he was not the type of composer who would just do something for the public, but he would do it out of a very deep feeling of what kind of music he wanted to compose. I think that if you hear Bach or you hear Bruckner, those two composers have the ability to clean your soul. At least that's my experience. So if we look at this season, St. Matthew Passion, Bach, Bruckner's Seventh Symphony. For me, those two pieces are the highlights of the season.